Jetzt. To put it simple, every resistance is coming from the ego. Every tension is the result of resistance.
Yes. You can say, no, I mean, we're creating tensions in different ways. In a lot is resistance, a lot is also we have contradictory tendencies simultaneously. I want to go left, I want to go right simultaneously. There's something there, part of me, I want it. No, I don't want it, I want it. This is how the mind is functioning. Monkey. But a lot of the pain that we are creating is just resisting to the fact of the experience. Instead of accepting the experience as it is and deal with it. Accepting the experience does not mean weakness. Not like as a victim. Okay, it's as it is, I cannot do anything. No, accepting that the experience is there. And then deal with it as creatively as you can. We have usually in our mind our whole list of things that we like and our whole list of things that we don't like. And of course we wanted the things to come that we like, and we struggle that they should come, and we are miserable if they don't come. And if they are there, then we don't want to let them go and just go in spite of that. There we are miserable again. You have this whole list of things we don't want to come. And they come in spite of that. There we are miserable again. And then we want to get rid of them as quickly as we can. And the more we struggle with it, the more we contribute that they don't go so quickly. And then we are miserable again. Somehow, all that resistance makes us miserable. Instead of learning to just accept. I mean, you can always bring your creativity, your beauty into the current. But you can accept what comes, in spite of your input. And deal with it, and let it go as it goes. And then, even if it changes from the pleasant experience to the unpleasant experience, it doesn't make you unhappy. It's not that the unpleasant experience makes us unhappy, but we think, no, 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 why me again? Poor me! And there, we build it up and build it up, and it's getting worse. But instead of that we can get to that broad-heartedness to accept, okay, it's coming, deal with it, and it's gone. The pleasant and the unpleasant. And then the past is past, it's gone, and every moment you are again new and beautiful and fresh.
One more question. You know, I'm in a process of trying to ignore, you know, thoughts and many things. Is there a certain, like, emotions? Or, you know, let's say when you do meditate, pleasant feeling comes, those things. I mean, I don't know the question. For Buddhists, you know, that, you know, they are big into cultivating, like, compassions, mm-hmm. things like that. Mm-hmm. Do we go with that kind of attitude? Or just, I mean, when we ignore certain many thoughts or feelings, do we have to include, I mean, should we include certain artificial happiness? Or, mm-hmm. I mean, which one to grab, which one to...
Which one to grab, which one to let go?
Do we let it go everything?
Do we have?
I mean, yeah, which one to grab, which one to let it go?
Yeah. Which one are the holy feelings and which one are the unholy feelings?
Right. Holy feelings, should we grab that? Or let it go too?
Emotions are emotions. Mm-hmm. They come, they have a peak, they go. So you let them come and go as they come and go. Now, you mentioned compassion. compassion is not really an emotion. We can be very emotional about being compassionate and make a big fuss and show about it. But the more you are at ease, at peace, at harmony with yourself, the less you feel separate. The more you become aware, you are connected with everything, and then compassion is simply natural. It's not an emotion. It's simply an awareness of being connected. And when you feel connected, you need not artificially create compassion and go out and do good things. If you feel that's what you have to do, by all means, do. But it's not that which matters. It's simply you feel the pain of living beings because you are not separate from it. And by connecting, it's already totally a compassionate act. And sometimes you may feel you act upon it, sometimes you may not feel that you act upon it. But just the fact that you connect is doing something to that suffering being, even if they are not aware of it. So it's not that you have to now be alert and wait which emotions that come I have to grab.
No, okay, so let's say we go through daily life.
Yes.
In the morning, we feel, many of us feel happy.
Yes.
You know, going to ashram. Do we emphasize on that, or we just watch that emotion too, let it go? Like, what other emotions? You know, those like a so-called like a happiness, yes, joy comes in. But do we focus on a little more, or just watch like any other emotions coming?
We can create joyous emotions, but that joyousness of existence is prior to the emotion. It's not an emotion. Actually, it's all the time there. Simply, we are most of the time not aware of it because we create too much tension experience.
But that joy before emotion you're talking about, then do we put a little bit more energy into it and we can keep going?
You don't have to put energy into it. You have to stop putting energy into preventing it. Let that fountain of existence simply bubble up all by itself. You don't have to somehow feed energy into it. It's already the source of energy.
But we can do even vice versa. I'm talking about, okay, I try to minimize putting focus on this I,
yes,
including thoughts, feelings, emotions.
Yes.
But there are amazing feelings coming sometimes,
right,
joy. Then what I do with this? Do I treat that joy is like other emotions? Just watch.
Just be with the joy and relax.
Okay. When joy comes.
Yes. Just be with that joy and relax. And wait and see what happens. Where it's bringing you.
You know, I was just going to say, I find sometimes when joy is coming up, just adding to this, that your attention goes there naturally.
Yeah.
And it tends to kind of continue more than, yeah, if you didn't. And if you try and do something, it's, yeah, it kind of puts the thing
I
on
know
it. But
that
if you,
attention is going there,
automatically.
Yeah. So I aware that. So, but do I put my awareness on joy, or do I put on this awareness and let the
I let it
joy
be wherever, whatever it goes to.
The joyousness is an aspect of that awareness. It's not that either the awareness or the joyousness. It's traditions, they tell us that you can come to a state of eternal bliss, mm-hmm, and people have continuously misunderstood that they imagine that eventually you are in a state of a perpetual ecstasy. But ecstasy is also an experience. It comes, it has a peak, it goes. Nothing wrong with that. Let the ecstasy come, let it go. But what they are talking about is not that you are eventually in a perpetual jumping ecstasy. There's something else which I would call a peaceful joyousness. And this is not something created. It's not dependent on circumstances. It's simply an aspect of existence. So it's not separate from that consciousness you are talking about. So actually, then it's not the question whether you should shift now to consciousness or to joyousness when you are aware of the joyousness. Just be with the joyousness, consciously. And there you are in consciousness. And that doesn't take something away from that experience of joyousness.
When sadness comes, just watch.
When sadness comes, then you just watch. Don't resist and don't think, oh, poor little me. But you just watch that sadness. Oh, and right. If you don't resist, it's not a terrible feeling. Then it's not a terrible experience. If we don't fight with sadness and that emotion comes, actually, just because we don't fight it, we are already acting against the usual reaction of the me ego personality. Because me ego, I don't want to be sad and I want to fight it. Accepting it, then suddenly that sadness can open up to become extremely beautiful and expansive. Like a sky in the winter night. Joyousness is not an emotion. We can create all kinds of joyous emotions that come and go, but it's not that we have to somehow grab that joyousness and make it bigger. Just deal with it and relax. And so you learn to create less and less obstacles to that joyousness of existence.